Hello friends, in this video we'll be discussing conformal mapping type number 2, that is bilinear transformation A. That means we're going to find bilinear transformation, and this will be our first example. Friends, till now we are done with type number 1, that is standard transformation. We took few examples of mixed category in which translation, magnification, rotation all were involved. Now we are starting with type number 2, that is bilinear transformation. Friends, bilinear transformation is very important, and you can expect at least one problem from this particular type. Bilinear transformation is also one of the transformation, but here we need to study it in details. So let's have a look what exactly bilinear transformation is. It is in the form W is equal to AZ plus B upon CZ plus D. First of all, you need to remember this. Bilinear transformation is always in forms of AZ plus B upon CZ plus D, and it is obtained by cross ratio property. And the cross ratio property says W minus W1, see the trick of writing 1, 2, 3 upon 1, 2, 3. Here it is W, here it is W. Right hand side, same way I am going to write Z. Z minus 1, 2, 3 upon 1, 2 and 3. So this is your cross ratio property. By using this property, I want result in terms of W is equal to AZ plus B upon CZ plus D. So friends, when I started teaching this topic, I found out very difficult. After few years, I found out few tricks of solving this particular type, that is bilinear transformation. And I have written few steps. If you follow that step, these problems were very simple. So let's have a look on the steps. These are the steps. Pause this video for few seconds or few minutes and please note down the steps. Let me read steps for you. The first step is put the values in the formula. Which formula? Cross ratio property formula. Step number 2 is convert the problem into Z plus Z minus W plus W minus format. And here, purposely some space is left. We'll see what is that exactly later on. Transfer the terms without W from LHS to RHS. Simplify RHS, componendo and dividendo. So these are the steps, and all the problems will be solved in this 5 steps. So let's have a look on the given problem and how to solve by using these particular steps. This is my first problem. Find BLT which maps the points onto the points. As we have discussed number of times, my aim is to map the points from Z plane to W plane. So here these points are to be mapped on these points. So these are the points of Z and these are the points of W. Make a note of it. First points are always Z and second points are always W. So here Z points and W points are given. Z is equal to 1i minus 1 and W is I 0 minus I. Let us name it as Z1, Z2, Z3, W1, W2, W3. So this is first point. Z1 is equal to 1, Z2 is equal to I, second point is Z2, third point is Z3, and W1 is equal to I, W2 is equal to 0, and W3 is equal to minus I. So these are the given points W and Z. Let us start solving the problem by cross ratio property. Remember, 1, 2, 3 upon 1, 2, 3. Same way, right hand side, it will be Z, 1, 2, 3 upon 1, 2 and 3. So, this is your cross ratio property. What next? Step number 1. We need to follow 5 steps. What are the steps? Step number 1. Put the values in the formula. Let us substitute these values in the given formula. So, W minus W1. W1 is I. W2 minus W3. W2 is 0. W3 is minus I. Here also minus. So, that will be plus upon W1 minus W2. I minus 0. And W3 minus W. W3 is minus I minus W. So let's substitute on right hand side. Z minus Z1. Z1 is 1. Z2 minus Z3. I plus 1 upon Z1 minus Z2. 1 minus I. And the last is Z3 minus Z. So, minus 1, minus Z. We are done with the first step. Put the values in the formula. What is the next step? Convert the problem into W plus, W minus, Z plus or Z minus format. Convert So, convert the problem into W plus, W minus, Z plus, Z minus format. So, let's convert it. The first term is W minus I. So, that will remain as it is. Why? Because we want W plus or W minus. Right? This is already W minus. W minus I. W minus. So, this is already W minus I. So, no need to change. Next term is I. 0 plus I means simply I upon. In the denominator, we do have this I. So, that will remain as it is. And here we have minus W. See here, we do have minus W. But what I said, convert it into W plus or W minus. Means W with W, we don't want minus sign. So, I am going to take minus common from these two terms. So, if I will take minus common, this will become W plus I. Now it is converted into W plus format. Confused? Let's see in the next case. On right hand side, this is already Z minus 1. So no need to do anything because this is Z minus already. I plus 1 will keep it as it is upon 1 minus I will also keep it as it is. And see here. Same story. What we need to do? Convert it into Z minus Z plus format. So, we need to take this minus common. So, if you take minus common, you will get Z plus 1. This will be cancelled. I will be cancelled. Now, see here, every term is W plus W minus Z plus Z minus format. W minus, W plus, Z plus. Let's move on to the next step. Step number 3. What is the step? Transfer the terms without W from LHS to RHS. Now here, see, there are only two terms in LHS. These are the two terms. In numerator, we have W minus I. In the denominator, we have W plus I. And what the step says, transfer terms without W from LHS. In LHS, there are only two terms, W minus I, W plus I, both contains W. Without W means we want terms like I or let's say 1 plus I, something like that. So, only two terms, both contains W. So, therefore, this step is not applicable here. We want to transfer those terms without W. So there are no terms without W. Therefore, this step is not applicable. So we'll move on. What is the next step? Step number 4 is simplify RHS. Step number 3 was not there. We need to simplify RHS. We do have W minus I upon W plus I, Z minus 1, I plus 1 upon Z plus 1, 1 minus I. What does simplification means? We need to open the brackets on RHS. So let's open the brackets. So Z will be multiplied to both the terms. So that will be ZI plus Z minus I minus 1 upon, in the denominator, Z minus ZI plus 1 minus I. And here we have W minus I upon W plus I. So we're ready with the step number 4. Now let's move on to the next step, that is step number 5. That is your componendo and dividendo. What the rule says, componendo, dividendo? Numerator plus denominator upon numerator minus denominator. So this is your numerator, this is your denominator, add. So if you add numerator plus denominator, this term, upon numerator minus denominator. Numerator is W minus I, minus of denominator. So minus of this term, minus W minus I. Same story here. This is numerator, this is denominator. Numerator plus denominator. ZI plus Z minus I minus 1. This is numerator plus denominator. Plus Z minus ZI plus 1 minus I upon numerator minus denominator. So ZI plus Z minus I minus 1. This is numerator minus of this term. So this will be minus Z plus ZI minus 1 plus I. Let us simplify. This is cancelled. This is cancelled. This is cancelled. This one also. This is gone. This is also gone. So left with, here we are left with 2W. And in the denominator, minus 2I. So 2W upon minus 2I, which is equal to right hand side, Z, Z, 2Z minus I, minus I is minus 2I. 2z minus 2i upon zi, zi will become 2zi minus 1, minus 1 is minus 2. So minus zi, 2zi minus 2. So if you take 2 common, this will be cancelled. If you take 2 common in the numerator, 2 common in the denominator, if you multiply this minus I this side, so that will be W is equal to minus I, Z minus I upon ZI minus 1. If minus I goes inside, this will be minus ZI, this minus I into minus I. Minus minus plus, but I square value is minus 1 upon ZI minus 1. This is the required result. Now let us check whether it is in the form of W is equal to AZ plus B upon CZ plus D or not. This is your BLT, that is bilinear transformation. So if you compare this with this, you can get the value of ABCD. So A is whatever we have with the Z is A. So with the Z we have minus I. B is the constant term, that is this. C is I here, and D is minus 1. So friends, by applying these 5 steps, we got our result and we converted, or we found out basically, bilinear transformation of the given points. In the next video, we'll be discussing few more examples. Thank you.